You're watching Grizzly News Network.
Good morning, Grizzlies. Today is Friday, November 18th. I'm Chela Gonzalez.
And I'm Dania Verastico. Here's what we're covering right now on GNU.
The end of the semester is less than a month away. Details on date and times for semester exams.
Plus, the results are in and we have a winner. Details on what middle school raised the most canned for the canned food drive, getting a Grizzly pep rally later in the show.
And
competition's a big deal because it gets Northside cheer out there and it shows everyone what we're capable of and the skills we have.
The Chief Squad is going to competition for the first time in years. How they plan to put the Grizzly cheer team back on top.
All these things and more on your Grizzly News.
I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen do it. Screams from the haters, got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man should have all that.
Hey guys, it's Emily Adventures coming back at you with Grizzlies on the Go. What's a fashion trend that needs to die?
Anything from Route 21. Specifically, the paint splatter pants.
What's a fashion trend that needs to die?
To be honest, bro, jeans with cowboy boots, bro. You wanna know why? Who are you trying to impress these days, bro? Ain't nobody trying to look cute now, bro. We're here to learn, not to party, you feel me?
The Edgar haircuts.
Why?
Cause it's not cool. Look like they got bangs.
People wearing tight clothes, like tight jeans. Tight jeans. Because they're wearing tight jeans whenever they can't barely breathe.
In 3 weeks, the semester would come to an end. For most students, that means semester exams.
But there are ways where you don't have to take them. If you don't have more than 3 parent permission days, have a C or higher, and no more than 3 tardies in one or more of your classes, you don't have to take the semester exams.
But remember, 3 tardies equal 1 absence, so be sure to check with your teachers for clarity. Here's a list of the semester exam dates and times.
Monday, December 19th will be 1st period, 3rd period, 5th period, and 7th period.
Tuesday, December 20th will be 2nd period, 4th period, and 6th, and a makeup period.
Wednesday, December 21st, will also serve as a makeup day.
Over the last few weeks, we have been talking about Northside's annual canned food drive. The freshman, sophomore, junior, and senior class have been competing in their goal to collect the most canned food items. These items will go to help deserving individuals at the Salvation Army. The class that donated the most cans will earn claws.
Parking on campus could now cost you. If you drive to school and want a better parking spot, you'll have to pay. A parking spot will cost you $40. You can see Mrs. Meeker if interested. If you do park in a parking spot that has been paid for, you will get a ticket or get towed. The moral of this story is do what's right and park where you're supposed to. Here's a look at the parking spots that have been paid.
Grizzlies, if you haven't placed your order for a yearbook, now is the time to get that done. This is a cool way to remember all your high school memories. Stop by room 242 to place your order. Yearbooks will cost you $60.
Seniors, if you have applied to college, please sign one of these banners located throughout the school. The counselors have placed them throughout the school for you to sign. You can find them by the cafeteria, outside the counseling office, and inside the counseling office hallway. October is college application month, and we hope to have these banners completely filled with your names. If you haven't applied yet, then do so now and sign the banner.
Seniors, graduation is still some time away, but it's never too early to apply for free money. Bellpoint Masonic Lodge 20 is continuing to support local seniors achieve their dreams of going to college. On Tuesday, December 6th, they will hold a fundraiser at Fish City Grill. Their goal is to raise $5,000 to give to a few deserving graduating seniors. If you are interested, stop by room 107 to see Mr. Deaton or scan the flyer outside his door.
Interested in becoming a future healthcare professional and you are enrolled in a healthcare related class? You should consider joining HOSA, or Health Occupations Students of America. Please stop by Mrs. Bean or Dr. Thomas if you have any questions.
Looking ahead, the eSports annual blood drive, it kicks off December 1st, and those who donate will earn a t-shirt. As we mentioned, the event is sponsored by the eSports team. When you donate, you can stop by room 104 to get signed up.
Now it's time for sports, but before we get an update on this week's basketball games, we want to invite everyone out tomorrow to watch the Cheer Squad as they compete against area squads and few from other states. This is the group's first time back at competition in years, and senior co-captain Kinley Smith and junior second base Georgia Beasley say they worked hard to get where they are and would love the support of the student body.
Y'all should come support us because we support you at every single game. We're always there. Rain, cold, we're always there. So y'all should just come support us because we work super hard for this.
You can catch the Grizzly Cheer Squad in action next Saturday at Alma High School. Things get started at 9:30 and last until 1. Good luck, guys.
What's up, Grizzlies? Welcome back to another edition of 90 Second Sports. I'm your host, Anna Gooden. Let's get into it. As we all know, or maybe you didn't know, our Grizzly football team went to the state playoffs last Friday. They went face-to-face with the Rogers Mounties. Sadly, the Grizzlies lost this game. The ending score was 38-7. As it was the end of our Grizzly football season, it is now the beginning of the basketball season. The Lady Bears and the Grizzlies had their first official game of the 2022-2023 basketball season on Tuesday. They played the Alma Airedales. Both Northside teams finished with wins for the night. The score of the Lady Bears game was 50-29, with Cherish Blackman having the first 7 points of the game. The Grizzlies, on the other hand, had an ending score of 66-42. The next official game will be next Tuesday during Thanksgiving break against the Jacksonville Titans. Remember, if you want your sports games aired here on GNN, email those results to Ms. Jennings at ojennings@fortsmithschools.org. All right, that's all I've got for you this week. Thank you for tuning in to 90 Second Sports.
Remember, with basketball season underway, the rules for buying tickets for sporting events have changed. They are all bought online. All you have to do is go to ticketspigot.com, find the school and team you want to buy the ticket for, and purchase from there. Or you can also scan the QR codes around the school and at the front of the ticket booth if that works better for you. That link again is ticketspigot.com.
Well, that's it for this week. Remember, we are out for Thanksgiving next week. Happy Thanksgiving, Grizzlies, and we will see you here after break.
Bye.
Spinning, the force from the beginning.